In this example, we're going to find the area of the surface generated when y equals the square root of 2x plus 1 between x equals 0 and x equals 5 is revolved around the x-axis. So here I've just provided a graph of our function, y equals the square root of 2x plus 1. And what's happening is that we are taking a segment of this curve, and that's the segment between x equals 0 and x equals 5. And we're revolving that curve around the x-axis, and when we do that, it's going to create a surface. And actually, I'm going to show you really quick what that surface looks like. So here's my curve, square root of x plus 1. And if I take between x equals 0 and x equals 5 and revolve it around the x-axis, I get a surface that looks like this. Okay, so notice this isn't a solid. Not a solid shape, but just the surface. And my goal is to find the area of this surface. So we actually have a formula for surface area that we just looked at. And so let me write down that formula for us here. So I have the integral from a to b of 2 pi f of x times the square root of 1 plus f prime of x squared dx. And this formula is applicable when f of x is a positive and differentiable function on the interval a, b. And when I revolve that function on the interval a, b around the x-axis, this integral is going to give me the area of the surface it's generated. So then once we have this formula, really all we're doing is plugging in the various pieces and then evaluating the integral if we can. So let's write out what our different pieces are. So first, of course, I have f of x, which is just my function, square root of 2x plus 1. And then I'm also going to need to find its derivative. You'll see that f prime of x appears in this formula. Okay, so f of x I could write as 2x plus 1 to the 1 half power. So if I take that derivative, I'm going to get 1 half times 2x plus 1 to the negative 1 half power. And then because of the chain rule, I need to multiply by a 2. So it looks like in the end, if I simplify, this is going to give me 1 over the square root of 2x plus 1 is the derivative. And then I'm looking at the interval from 0 to 5. So those are my a and b values, respectively. Okay, so maybe one more thing before we actually plug into our integral. We're going to want to know f prime of x squared. So let's go ahead and square that derivative and see what we get. So I have my derivative here, and I'm going to square it. Okay, so if I do that, I'm going to get 1 over 2x plus 1. So then if I go back to my integral, I've got the integral from 0 to 5. And actually, let's go ahead and pull that 2 pi out front just to make things a little nicer. Then I've got f of x, so that was the square root of 2x plus 1 times the square root of 1 plus my derivative squared, which is this expression here, 1 over 2x plus 1. And we're going to integrate with respect to x. So that was the easy part, right? Setting up the integral is not too bad. It's just plug and chug. But now we actually, in this case, want to evaluate this integral. And these can be a little tricky because of the square roots, but sometimes, if the problem is nice, there might be a little bit of algebraic manipulation you can do that will allow you to evaluate the integral. So let's see what we might try in this case. So I notice I have two square roots here being multiplied by each other, so I can put that under a single square root. Right, the product of the square roots is the square root of the product. So what then I have is under the square root, I'm going to have 2x plus 1 times the quantity 1 plus 1 over 2x plus 1. And that looks pretty nice. If I distribute under that square root, if I distribute the 2x plus 1, that is, I am going to get 2x plus 1, and then plus 1, right? If I multiply 2x plus 1 times 1 over 2x plus 1, it just gives me plus 1. So then, it looks like what I end up with is a square root of 2x plus 2 dx. So that's a good bit simpler than what we started with, and that is something that we can actually evaluate. But to do that, we're just going to need to do a little u substitution. So I'm going to let u equal 2x plus 2. So then du is going to be the derivative of that, 2dx, or I could write 1 half du equals dx. And then we should go ahead and transform our bounds into u values as well. So I've got x equals 0, and I'm just going to plug that in to my u expression here to figure out what that is in terms of u. So 2 times 0 plus 2 gives me 2. And then I will do the same with 5, transform it to a u value. So 2 times 5 plus 2 is going to give me 12. So now I can rewrite my integral completely in terms of u. So I get the integral 2 pi out front, and then my new bounds are from 2 to 12. And I've got the square root of u, which I'm going to write as u to the 1 half. Okay, and then dx was 1 half du. All right, so I need this factor of 1 half in my du. So if I pull that 1 half out front, this is going to give me pi times the integral from 2 to 12 of u to the 1 half du. So if I take the antiderivative of u to the 1 half, it's going to give me u to the 3 halves over 3 halves. I still have my pi out front, and I'm evaluating from 2 to 12. I can write that as 2 pi over 3 u to the 3 halves. And then I just need to plug in my bounds. So 2 pi over 3 out front, and then I'm going to have 12 to the 3 halves. Minus 2 to the 3 halves. Neither one of those are nice, friendly numbers, so we will just leave our answer in this form. And this is the surface area. So this would be square units, whatever your units may be. All right, so this is how you can find the surface area when a curve is revolved around the x-axis.